Yeah. Breakfast at Tiffany's and bottles of bubbles. Girls with tattoos who like getting in trouble. Lashes and diamonds, ATM machines. Buy myself all of my favorite things. Been through some bad shit, I should be a savage. Who would've thought it turned me to a savage? Rather be tied up with calls and not strings. Write my own checks like I write what I sing. Yeah. My wrist, stop watching. You like my hair? Gee, thanks, just bought it. I see it, I like it. I want it, I got it, yeah. I want it, I got it. I want it, I got it. I want it, I got it. I want it, I got it, yeah. You like my hair? Gee, thanks, just bought it.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Is that what the YouTubers and stuff say? You guys, look how cute my little brother looks. Anyways, so today I'm making a video. I haven't made a video in a long time, and I decided why not make one, you know? And this is gonna be like a really good video. So today I'm gonna be answering my most asked question, and that would be how I became a model, how I got started, how to get started, where to start, all that type of stuff. And before I get into the video, I just want to say, y'all see this watch? Hold on, wait a minute. Oh, y'all see that? Yes. If you like my watch, go to mvmt.com and use my code abukdeng15, that's abukdeng15, for 15% off a movement watch. Like, yes, Rolly on my wrist, okay? I'm kidding, it's not a Rolly, but I'll put the link in the description somewhere. And click on it, go buy a watch, use my code, 15% off. Yes. Before I start, I just wanna say, modeling is a very, 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 very hard thing to get into. Like, it's very hard because a bunch of agencies, they have really high requirements and expectations for people, and they literally want you to be perfect. So sometimes it can be really hard to get, like, you know, attention from certain agencies or whatever. But I think if you really want to become a model and you don't think that you meet the requirements or the standards of what a model should look like, I think you should still go out and do it. Like, even if you're not tall enough, if you're thick, you're not skinny enough, whatever it may be, still go out there and do it. Put your mind to it, speak it into existence, work hard, try, and you can honestly accomplish it. Like, there is no telling what you can do if you really put your mind to something. So if you want to become a model and it's a couple people doubting you or not believing in you, don't listen to them. Still do it, still try, still go after it. Anyways, the first thing you can do to become a model, I would say, is build a portfolio. And a portfolio is pretty much, it's like a resume for models. And a portfolio is pretty much a book with a bunch of pictures of models and the things, you know, their pictures, the things they do. And when building a portfolio, you don't want to have like 30 pictures of the same thing in like a portfolio. Like, you want to have a bunch of different outfits, a bunch of different looks, a bunch of different, you know, ideas, a bunch of different things. Because when agencies look at your portfolio and you have a variety of things, they're gonna be like, oh, this girl or guy knows exactly what they're doing. Like, they have experience in a whole bunch of different things, you know? And being a model is pretty much being able to step out of your comfort zone and do things that sometimes you might not be comfortable with or that are somewhat crazy. Because, like, for example, like, some models do crazy things, like shoot in cold weather in swimsuits or whatever it may be. So when I say stepping out of your comfort zone and doing things you don't like to do, I don't mean literally things you don't like to do. I just mean like things that can sometimes be uncomfortable but still worth it, you know? So try and get some pictures of, you know, you in a swimsuit, on the beach or something, some pictures in the snow, some pictures in a tree, whatever. Just get creative and have a bunch of different pictures, styles, outfits, looks, hair, makeup, all that, and put them all into one big portfolio so that the agencies can look at it and know that you have experience in a lot of different things. Second, I would say local gigs, photo shoots, fashion shows, whatever. Do local stuff. Like if there's a photo shoot or a fashion show or a whatever in your area, or if a designer is looking for models to shoot for her clothing line or whatever it is and it's in your area, go out and attend those things, audition, apply, whatever it is, but attend those things, because starting locally, doing local things is a good way to start and build yourself, because then the people in your area start to realize that you are serious about what you want to do, and they will start to take you serious and see that, you know, you're really serious and that you really want to do this. So do that, start locally, and then once you've, you know, become known in your area, then start going big to like New York, California, Miami, or whatever, and start doing shows and photo shoots and gigs out there, and that will get you a lot of exposure. Like that's really a lot of exposure. Instagram is the best out of all of them, because that's where most of the agents, scouts, you know, agencies, models are, is Instagram. So post pictures, professional pictures, use hashtags, tag pages, whatever, like just post a lot on social media, because even if you don't have that many followers, eventually you will build your following. The more you get into it, the more your following will grow. So do that. Social media, it's a really good way to get exposure, and even if you don't have that many followers, it's okay, you can still do it. Applying to opportunities, and what I mean by this is, with being a model, opportunities aren't just gonna come to you. You actually have to go out there and look for these opportunities and go and get them yourself. So if you see a casting for a New York Fashion Week thing, apply to that, attend the audition, and, you know, do whatever it takes to get into stuff like that. So whatever opportunities there are, photo shoots, any of that stuff, just apply to them, go to them. And like I said, you'll learn really good things, because not only do you get experience from doing these things, but you also get exposure. So yeah, like go after these opportunities. Don't just sit there and expect, you know, for it to come to you. You actually have to get up and go do something and, you know, try. So I think that's all for today. I can't really think of anything else that, you know, is like one of the main things, but yeah, I think that's all I have for today. If you feel like I missed something, or if there's something else you want to know, follow me on Instagram or Twitter or Facebook, and yes, I follow back and I reply to messages, so I'm gonna put like my social media somewhere in the description. Follow me, and we can have a one-on-one conversation about anything else that you guys want to know or that I missed. So message me personally and we can do that. And if you like this video, please share it, like it, comment, whatever, subscribe, you know, that's what the YouTubers say, all that good stuff. I really appreciate it. And yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. Like I said in the beginning, if it's really what you want to do, go after it, and you can really do it. Like, I believe in you guys, whoever you are, I think you can do it. And even if you don't believe in yourself, I mean, if you're doubting yourself, that kind of doesn't help, because when you doubt yourself, you kind of have this simple mindset where you don't think you're good enough, and that's not good. Okay, you gotta believe in yourself. That's also one of the main things in being a model, is you have to believe yourself, because the industry is a very, very, very hard place where people tear each other down continuously, people doubt each other, people hate on each other. So believing in yourself is going to be the main thing that's going to keep you on top, because if you don't let anybody tear you down, the more you believe in yourself, the more you are going to build yourself and get up there. Okay, so it might sound cliche and corny, but it's true. Seriously, like, believe in yourself, and you can honestly do it. Like, I kid you not, you can really do it if you believe in yourself. So yes, if you're watching this, thank you so much for watching. I hope this helps a lot of you who ask me these questions. Like I said, if there is anything you feel I missed or whatever, just message me personally and we can talk about it. And yeah, bye guys, thanks for watching.